Hey everybody, Josh Bentley, and as you can tell, I'm not dressed in my normal developer advocate outfit. I am standing at the S Fashion Store, which is an SAP's experience center in New York City in our Hudson Yards office. We have 26 experience centers around the world, as well as some pop-up different experiences like our factory experience in Newtown Square. So lots of places where you can come and meet with the SAP experts and talk about code. And that's really what I learned here today, is that a developer can come into this location and get exposed to not only the SAP experts and all the different code, but they can ideate and have fun as a playground with some of the actual people that want to showcase their products in the SAP store. This one in New York City is dedicated to fashion. We call this the S Fashion Store. And you can come in and see different things that are available for clothing and different bags and other things that are available in a retail store environment. We've got a smart mirror behind me so you can personalize things, and that's done using, you know, artificial intelligence, and it takes all the insights from artificial intelligence to see what you may want based on the clothing that you took into the changing room. So it's not a real changing room, it's just a smart mirror, but in a changing room environment, you would go in with a piece of clothing and you could actually contact the salesperson and say, hey, I want something else, this isn't the right size or a different color, and it will be able to tell you what's in stock. If it's not in stock, it'll be able to tell you where it is available based on inventory management. We've got a robot wandering around in here doing the inventory management. It can pull things off the shelf. And then we've also got a perfume manufacturing section where you can go answer some questions and you have a custom scent made for you. So really cool things to experience and play with here. You can also learn about the sustainability model of several of the vendors. Some of them want to go into the SAP Experience Center and showcase how they're making the world a better place. And one of the vendors is collecting fishing nets, and they are actually making those fishing nets into clothing. So it's really nice that you can get some swimwear that's actually created out of old, dirty fishing nets that were found in the ocean. So a lot of great stories that I learned just from being here today for this fashion show. And if you have a chance to go tour one of the SAP Experience Centers, I highly recommend you do it. I'm going to go now and go make my own personal scent. So I'm not sure what it's going to come up with, but I'm going to go see what I get. Hope you guys come by. Talk to you later.
Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. So listen, folks, I know there may still be a little confusion out there about ABAP Cloud and what that all means. To help clear things up a bit, a new ABAP Cloud FAQ has been created and posted to the SAP community. This FAQ provides answers to the most common questions on ABAP Cloud, clean core, key user extensibility, SAP BTP ABAP environment, also known as Steampunk, and SAP S/4HANA Cloud ABAP environment, also known as Embedded Steampunk, public APIs, and the three-tiered extensibility model. So if you still have some unanswered questions about ABAP Cloud, please check out the FAQ today.
You might have seen that this year is the big 20th anniversary of the SAP community. Craig Spahel posted in the Community Coffee Corner, kicking off the big anniversary event, asking people to share pictures from past community events and other fun get-togethers. And that's what the community is really a lot about. It's not just a website where we go to ask and answer questions. It's about connecting with each other, sharing knowledge, and having a little bit of fun along the way. In support of that, the Developer Advocate team is going to be doing a lot of code jams this year. And in particular, to celebrate the 20th anniversary, we're going to have our biggest ever roadshow, a major series of code jams back-to-back in many different cities. Starting in March and running the last 3 weeks of March, we're going to do 10 code jams in 9 different cities across 2 continents and 4 different countries. We'll be bringing both the ABAP Cloud and the Cloud Application Programming Model topic to these various cities in the UK, Germany, Netherlands, and the United States. You can check out the calendar of events of upcoming code jams and read all about it in the description of this video. And if we're not hitting a city near you, consider putting in your request to host a code jam of your own in your own city. Maybe that way you can be part of the next time we do a roadshow, hopefully coming to you later this year.
Howdy, developers. The SAP Developer Insight Survey is still running, but the window is closing. The survey will end at the end of the month of February. If you've already taken the time to fill out the survey, I want to take a second to say thank you. It's much appreciated. If you haven't had the time yet, it'll only take 10 minutes. You can click on the link below and do it right now. A report on the survey will be available in the month of March. Thanks.
Hi, everyone, and welcome to SAP Developer News. Version 3 of the UF5 tooling was released last week. It's the biggest release so far, and it's packed with new features and announcements. For example, you can now use UF5 workspaces to create local UF5 dev environments, to consume UF5 libraries locally, but without the need for NPM links, for example. Version 3 now also includes all dependencies when building your UF5 projects by default. This was previously achieved via the UF5 build --all command, but it's now the default, which is pretty sweet. The extension API for custom tasks and middleware was enhanced, so in case you are using custom extensions, you can now make them more lightweight. The UF5 dependencies section in the package.json is now obsolete and ignored, so feel free to just kick it out. When upgrading to version 3 of the UF5 tooling, make sure you're using Node version 16.18 or higher, or 18.12 or higher. And make sure to check out the link in the description below for more information.
Volker Buzek has just highlighted the fact that 2023 is going to be a peak conference year for all you SAP UI5 and SAP Cloud Application Programming Model developers, as UI5Con and RecapConf are back-to-back on July 6th and 7th on-site and at the same location, St. Leon Roth in Germany. The call for speakers for UI5Con 2023 is now open. Any topic of interest is welcome. This is your chance to share experiences from your own projects, give hints and tips, deep dive into a special topic, or explain how you integrate SAP UI5 with other technologies. Also, SAP community member Sasha Siegerbach has posted about BTPCon, which is a community conference around the topics of SAP Business Technology Platform. That will take place on April the 14th in Hanover, and their call for papers is also open. Check out the announcements in the links below.